Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and today we are with a really interesting tutorial and the latest update which Shopify has made. So they have launched Shopify 2.0 in the month of June, and as we all know, adding custom fields was really a pain using liquid code in the old Shopify setup. But today we'll be learning how to add that in Shopify 2.0, which is relatively easy as compared to the old version of the Shopify. So before getting into it, please subscribe my channel, comment on the video below, like and share so I can create more videos for you guys. Now let's jump into the tutorial. So after June 29, 2021, Shopify have completely changed the theme setup. They have added the JSON functionality and moved some template files from here to there, and they have added a new Dawn theme. Dawn theme, and we can also connect it with our GitHub, connect from here. Also, the coolest thing which we have here is the meta fields, which I'm gonna show you guys how to add in this video. So here's the meta fields. We can add meta field and display it on a product page dynamically, which is a really a cool feature. Now let me show you how you can add a field right now. Now let's add a text field. Okay, so let me name this field as brand, and as you can see, namespace has already been updated once I name the field. Now leave the description as it is, select it as the text field. As you can see, we have multiple options here. We can add a color picker, we can add a date and time field, we can also add a file, an image, or any upload file which we can do. I'll also teach you guys how to add a file thing, but first let's do the text field, and let's add a single line text, minimum length to maximum length 20. We can also add regular expression. If you guys know about regular expression, it's really a great way to customize the input from the customer. And now let's save the field. Now if we go back to our theme, and let's go to theme, and go to customize, here we can see how our default product page will look like. So that's one of the product which we have in our store, and as you can see, these fields are coming dynamically when you click on title. Okay, so text, here you can see vendor, so that's the vendor of this product. Now if we go to the back end of this product, let's go to the product which we have open here, Star Wars t-shirt. As you can see, we have this vendor showing up here dynamically, which we can edit quite easily. In the old Shopify setup, it was not that simple to edit a dynamic field. It was really back and forth with the liquid code and stuff like that. Now we can do it really easily, and as you can see, the meta field which we created is showing up here. In the old Shopify setup, we were not able to add any custom fields and on the back end of the Shopify without the access of apps and stuff, but now we can do it really easily by the option which they have given us in settings. Now let me add the brand name here to any random brand name like Adidas. Let's name it this. Hit save, and now go to the customize and add block and add our field as text. So when we added it, brand, and add the dynamic value, insert dynamic source, Here we will find our brand name and insert. There we go. Our brand name is showing up here. And if we check it on the other product, so when we go to the second product which we have in our store, it won't display it because we do not have that defined. Let's see. As you can see, this product is not showing up any vendor field. Now when we go to the white shirt which we added, we'll be able to see the brand name. Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot to hit save here. Let's hit save and hit refresh. There we go, our brand is showing up. Cool, right? It was really hard to do it in the old Shopify setup, but we in Shopify 2.0, it just took like a minute or two to add the dynamic field, which we can display anywhere in our product page. We can just drag and drop product information. We can add it on the top. If we just drag it and put it on the top, we can display it. We can see. So that's a really simple way to add the dynamic field in our Shopify 2.0 store. I hope you guys like the tutorial. If you guys want to learn more about Shopify 2.0, please comment on the video below so I'll be able to create more videos. So I have been receiving requests for creating more videos for WordPress, Elementor, stuff like that, and I'm getting more views in Shopify. So I just want you guys to tell me which type of videos you would like to see in the channel so I can create more content for you guys. Have a great day.